Hi everyone, it's Anne at Martin House Flowers. Before I get started in today's video, I want to do a special shout out to Janey at Dig Plant Water Repeat. She included me in her Show Me Your Gardens 2.0 of Zone 5, and I was so thrilled to be included in all of those beautiful gardens that she featured on that video. So please join me in thanking Janey for including all of those beautiful gardens. That was such a great series, and I will include that link in today's video. So thank you again, Janey. I really appreciated being included in that video of the Show Me Your Gardens 2.0. Thank you so much. So today's video, I just wanted to share with you some of the things that we did over the weekend, this past weekend, where we were working in the garden and cutting some flowers. My stepdaughter saw a bouquet that I had on the kitchen table, and so she immediately wanted to pick some flowers and make an arrangement of her own. So here we are doing the wiggle test and identifying which flowers are ready to be picked. If they're too floppy like that one, they're not ready, and if you wiggle them and they're a nice stiff stem, then they're ready to go. There's a view of the stem and the branching stems below. So she ends up cutting right above the branching stems on the left and to the right. And then she strips the leaves. And here, she's already got a good start on the bouquet. And she decided to also cut some of my little lime hydrangeas. I had waited until this week to cut on those shrubs. We actually have 10 of the little lime hydrangeas as a hedge on the in the backyard. On the, let's see, that would be the east side of the backyard. And if any of you are noticing when you cut your little limes or your limelight hydrangeas, to avoid them flopping, you wait till you see them, make sure that the blooms are completely fully bloomed, and that there's usually a hint of a rose color, and they're almost ready to be dried at this point. Probably in the next few weeks you can cut and dry them. So so in her bouquet she has some salvia, she has some African daisies, snapdragons, of course, the Benares giant pink, and the coral. And that hydrangea in the front there is actually a bloom-struck hydrangea. It's already gotten that old rose look to it and can definitely dry in that color. So I think she did a really nice job. The only change I made to it at the end was I pulled, she had three of those little lime hydrangeas on the left side there, and they were, it was a little bit side heavy, so I pulled one out and put it at the top just to balance it out a little bit. But the marigolds, she loved those marigolds. They're so nice and fluffy and pom-pom like. And of course the cosmos, the cupcake cosmos, I think she really loved the African daisies with the blue centers in them. So I think she did such a nice job on this. It's so pretty, and of course she loves it. She's talking about how she wanted it full. And she's got some of the black knight snapdragons that are kind of a little spent, but I suggest that she put them in the front lower area there just to fill up some spaces. One thing I noticed in our cut flower choices, we don't have a lot of greenery in our raised beds, and I think I'm gonna have to work on that for next year. I had hoped that the stock that we had grown in the early part of the season would be a nice filler, but they didn't last very long. And I actually liked stock as just a on its own. There's a not a celosia, but an amaranth that she's just put in there in this beautiful, rich burgundy, almost purpley burgundy color. And the snapdragons, which continue to bloom. We spent a lot of time this weekend just cutting back the spent blooms on the snapdragons, hoping that we'll get another flush of them. We're probably on our, gosh, third or fourth flush of snapdragons. I'm so thrilled with how they've really lived up to their name, cut and come again. Cosmos are a little bit late on the blooming, so they're just coming out now. And the marigolds continue to do really well in the veggie garden. So there you go. She's pretty much got it complete, and she wanted that pom-pom. I call it the pom-pom marigold in the top as a feature. She loved how it just popped up. And for someone who's 12, I think she's got quite the eye. Look at that. And we use the greenery of the marigold flower to fill in some space. After planting my two quick fire hydrangeas that I had picked up from Proven Winners Direct, I did the no-dig method of continuing the bed with the other quick fire fabs by laying cardboard and mulch all around. And I still have to go in there and edge it all properly so it's more cohesive and continuous with the other bed. And I'll continue that to the bed with the clematis at the edge of this arbor here. But I wanted to just take a little walk down the cut flower garden, see how the zinnias have all caught up. The direct sow ones here have caught up nicely. They're starting to bloom and we're starting to cut on them next to the taller zinnias that were sowed using the soil block method. So you can see there that the red, white, and blue bed is doing really well. We've got some African daisies here, some bachelor's buttons, and the cucumber that are now starting to climb the arbor. So there you have it. There is the hydrangea room with my Bobo hydrangeas, little limes, quickfire fab, quickfires. These are bloom strucks. And because she was still waiting for her friend to come over for a visit and a bike ride, she asked if she could do anything else with the pruners. She loves using those pruners. And I said that she could go ahead and cut back the alyssum and we'll see whether or not we get a second or third flush from the alyssum. I went ahead and fertilized after we had cut back all of these annuals, strawberries as well. They were supposed to be hanging in the greenhouse, but the greenhouse hasn't been ready to hang anything yet, so hopefully we get those up before the season's up. So I also have some alyssum from seed here in the pots surrounding the boxwoods, and come fall I will carry these nice lightweight pots into the greenhouse. And you'll see right next to this pot some of the you'll see the little foliage there of the snapdragons as well as the cosmos. I love this area by the greenhouse, just in front of the greenhouse. It's along the pathway from the garage into the greenhouse. It gets nice shade. It's probably the only working space in the garden where I have shade from about 2 o'clock onwards. So it's a perfect place to do some potting and harden off the seedlings that I start indoors under grow lights. So this year it'll be really a different change because I'll be able to do some seed starting in the greenhouse. And in terms of spring plantings of cut flowers, I think I might start as early as January, February for pansies. I already ordered some pansies for with fall colors, and I'm not sure if I'll get any pansies blooming for fall, but I'm going to experiment anyway. So after doing this alyssum, there was also some of the annuals on the patio to cut back. Once you notice your annuals like Supertunias getting a little bit long and draping over the pots, if you notice that they're getting a little dry, even if you're watering daily, it could be that they could benefit from a good haircut. Lifting up the foliage, you'll notice that there's probably some dry branches. It's a really good idea to go ahead and give those a nice cut, cut them back, and you'll get a nice fresh set of flowers that'll come through and grow through. So you can see there's a lot of dead branches there that were dying to get cut. So I went ahead and fertilized these as well. I ran out of my Proven Winners fertilizer, so I used my Jack's continuous release fertilizer, so that should work as well. Anything you have on hand is a good idea. And if we get another few weeks of fresh blooms on these annuals, I'll be happy, since it is already almost the end of summer. I can't believe I'm saying that. So while the girls were working in the garden, weeding, cutting back flowers, fertilizing, and all of those fun chores in the garden. Greg was busy back with the greenhouse. On my last video, I had let everyone know that he had gotten to the final stages of the greenhouse, and unfortunately, on the very last step on Sunday, last Sunday, he discovered that he had made an error in the measurement on the drawings, and basically he had been off by half an inch on the frame. And so the only solution was to take the base plate and shift it over by half an inch to the right. And in so doing this, he had to scrape all of the adhesive that was underneath the base plate that was attaching it to the concrete foundation. So you see him loosening all of the joints, and the unfortunate thing too was that he had to remove all of the glass panels on this gable front side of the greenhouse. But after all of that, when he finally went back to check, the door fit. That was the best news of the day. So it's Monday evening now. After a day's work, Greg started reinstalling the glass back onto the greenhouse. And before doing that, he had to clean each panel, wipe them all down, since they had been sitting for the weekend and getting dirty, and noticed that there was a lot of grime on them. And here he is installing the caps for the panels. And luckily, he had an extra roll of that adhesive strip that secured the glass onto the frame. I can't help but notice how beautiful the sunset is, and you can see that right through the glass of the greenhouse. I'm really looking forward to spending autumn nights in the greenhouse and being able to see that in the evening. So here's the aluminum cap that secures the glass panel onto each of the aluminum frames. So apparently I was making him nervous as I was filming, and he had put the strip on the wrong side. Apparently there's a very specific piece for each of the panels, and he had them laid out on the grass in order. It's a little bit frustrating, I think, for Greg, as everything is around him and he has to work around everything, since it was pretty much furnished around the greenhouse and in the greenhouse. But look at that gorgeous sunset. We get to see that on every one of our summer nights. So beautiful. So I'm super excited to get to the final stages again of the greenhouse. And by the time I publish this video, hopefully the greenhouse is complete and the door will be on, and the next step will be waiting for the hexagon bolts that we had to order from BC Greenhouse in British Columbia. They're sending out today some very specific 1 1/4 inch hexagon bolts so that we can install these Victorian style brackets for shelving that I had picked up, so that I can put some pots on the shelves of the walls of the greenhouse, so that I can maximize the height of the greenhouse with some shelving and add more storage. So that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed being with us on this weekend of just doing some average gardening tasks and finally solving our problem with the door on the greenhouse. And the next time you see us, I'll be walking you through the furnished greenhouse. And Hope that you had a wonderful weekend. We had an amazing few meals of fresh salad and cucumbers from the garden. We were able to share some with our friends and neighbors. And there's some sunflowers that were finally peeking through here in the raised bed, and of course the roses. So hope you will consider subscribing. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for joining us.